where we join and continue and push go before. So put a smile on your face, cause today now we all get back there.
Oh yeah, I'm in the kitchen, they ready to pepper chicken. Now you feel what I'm feeling, I say today now chilling, yeah.
Freetown party, yeah.
Freetown, Freetown.
Now we all young.
Fago, Fago.
We want to celebrate.
On 2030, yeah.
Entego.
Now so we go dance.
Dance and jubilate.
The baby, them all, they shake them tambourine. So then can do na magazine. We dey up and down the place like trampoline. We dey ready for go parade na Aberdeen. I sit down a yard with Pat and Caroline.
Carolina.
We talk baby then we get the melanin.
Melanina.
The papa don't give for lengthy limousine. We don't ready the fire, bring the kerosene.
Carolina.
From slavery to the land of the free.
Bring the kerosene.
I'm feeling, I say, see them that chilling, hello. Freetown party, yeah.
Event has been called to order. I'm kindly asking everyone to please be seated. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Good morning to our worship, the mayor of Freetown. Good morning to the representatives of the government ministers. Good morning to the German ambassador. Good morning to the heads of NGOs and great stakeholders such as the World Bank, JICA. Good morning to the UN rep present. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished ones, boys and girls. Today is a great day for Freetown, Sierra Leone. And when I say that, I want to see you with a smile. Today is the day that tech meets the hearts and needs of Freetonians. Have you ever heard about the word CableCar? Have you seen it? Not at all. But it is a pleasure to announce to you that we are launching the official Freetown CableCar. I see the young people are super excited. Have you ever thought about becoming a superman or woman? Boys and girls, have you ever thought about that? Well, this is our opportunity, because very soon we're going to be dashing across the skies of Freetown. We'll be seeing the backdrop of the green, white, and blue as we go about our businesses. If you want to progress, if you want to grow, and if you want to develop, the heart of all of that lies within transportation. Without much ado, I want to welcome our host, the Freetown City Council, Mariama Mrs. Whitmond, to give us the welcome opening remarks. Let's celebrate her. So she is the first to step into the cable car right now.
Thank you very much, Ariana. Good morning, everyone. On behalf of Freetown City Council, we would like to invite you and welcome you to our lovely space. I know we've got a few people here. I would not be able to name everybody, but I think as a matter of protocol, I worship the mayor, who's our guest for the day, together with, for the day. Sorry, I worship. I get the point, yes. Dignitaries around our councillors, on behalf of them, the German ambassador, representative, as Ariana has mentioned earlier on, ministries, departments, and agencies. So welcome to Freetown City Council. And throughout the next 2 hours, we will take you through the Freetown Cable Car Visibility Study. What are we going to do to prepare this thing to become a reality in Freetown? So get ready for the ride. For those of you that have never used the cable car, we have a few videos around to show you that will just give you a feel for it. And later on, we've got a baby cable car that we're gonna put on the stage so you can see what this thing actually looks like. So ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Freetown City Council. And without further ado, may I please hand the stage over to the ambassador from the Republic, the Federation of Germany.
Good morning, Your Worship, the Mayor of Freetown, representative of the head of the GIZ, representative of the World Bank, United Nations, representatives of the Freetown City Council. It gives me great pleasure, also of the press here, gives me great pleasure to give a welcoming word to you this morning, representing one of the funding partners of this event, funding partner being the German government. If you read funding partner and implementation partner, you see it the other way around. We are one of the funding partners, the German government. Cable car is a fantastic thing. I love cable cars. And cable car in Freetown, well, that is really a fantastic, that is an ambitious, a utopian vision. I stand here having the privilege of greeting you, not because now there is a German company waiting to build and operate the cable car in Freetown. And the German Development Corporation does not have a cable car in its portfolio at this time. But we do want to give an impulse to try and do the extraordinary, the outrageous, the unheard of. We must think outside of the box, as they say. We must break with business as usual strategies. Because all of us together, we face a dramatic climate change. We all know emissions of greenhouse gases must come down. If we want to avoid the worst disasters and secure the future of our children, the effects of climate change are already felt in many parts of the world, here too. And emissions are not on their way down, they are still rising. Cities play a crucial role in creating a livable future. More than half of the world's population lives in cities, and cities account for over 70% of global carbon dioxide emissions. I am happy that Germany, together with France and the United Kingdom, is co-funding the C40 Cities Finance Facility, the CCF. And I am pleased that this CCF chose to explore one activity here in Sierra Leone. The C40 Cities Financial Facility is supporting the development of new green infrastructure in cities across the world. Their projects are based around the world and focus on transportation, energy, and adaptation to the challenge of the changing climate. Freetown is a prime example of such a CCF partner city. Transport is one of the primary sources of carbon dioxide emissions here, and air pollution, about 30%, and the city wants to tackle this by improving an essential municipal service, public transport. Freetown and the CFF want to test the cable car's technical feasibility and financial viability, develop a business model, and eventually a procurement package for private sector involvement. I am curious about the outcome. I find the whole project very ambitious, as I have said, but it is absolutely worth studying. New things have to be developed if we want to make any headway in fighting the climate change and decongest an overly stuffed road network as it is in Freetown. I keep my eyes on Freetown in the years to come. I keep my fingers crossed, and I want to be amazed that the city succeeds getting a cable car in motion and that a private company makes money with it and that other private companies make money producing the necessary energy, climate friendly. And that is all I want to say here. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you so much to a German ambassador. That was not a very beautiful way to show appreciation. Mind you, they're one of our implementation partners. So we have to really, really show gratitude. CableCar in Freetown, implementing partners, the German government, the British government, and the French government. We are really, really excited and grateful to also the funding partners who happen to be GIZ and the CFF. So the CFF, everybody here is wondering what that's about. This is where the city, our city, got to make the amazing connection. There were over 60 applications in 2021. And Freetown, out of 60 other cities, was chosen. We were chosen to bring CableCar alive. And with that said, I want to bring on board Dr. Marco. He is going to walk us through the process. How did it happen? What do you want to know? Feel free to put him on the spot. He's given me the permission.
Yes. Should I take that one? Maybe that one. So give me a second. Hello, hello. Sorry for that. Thank you, Ariana, for the nice introduction. Thank you so much to everyone being present today. So honorable representatives of the government, honorable Madam Mayor, honorable Chairman Ambassador, thank you for the introduction remarks. So let me briefly explain what the CFF, the C40 Cities Finance Facility, is all about. And maybe we can put on the slides. That would be nice. Thank you so much. And the CableCar project, as we consider our support on preparing the project then for the private sector, make it attractive, have the business case at hand for the private sector to come in and to finance the project. Of course, the ultimate goal of the CFF as well is to enable our partner cities to replicate similar projects, the same project in scale in future without us. Then I would go one slide further. Here we see a very typical, sorry, the other one with the infrastructure investment cycle. What does the CFF do? Please could you go back one slide? Thank you so much. So what does the CFF do? And here we see very nicely how a typical infrastructure investment project cycle looks like. Typically, you would identify a problem, for instance, in the transport sector. Then you would start a planning with various projects, and you would identify the most, you know, the project with the best impact, addressing your challenges, and then you would prioritize the project as a city and go ahead. And then the blue boxes, this is where we come in. We support cities in the scoping, technical feasibility, financial viability, and the business case asset. And then the project implementation, operation, and maintenance in this context might be taken over by the private sector. And I think it's very important here maybe as well to stress, we expect cities to provide a mature project applying for CFF support. So we expect cities to have already pre-feasibility studies being done. And as has been mentioned, we received 86 applications from meager cities across the globe. And from 86 projects applications we received, we are now ending up with, at current stage, 14 projects, and Freetown being amongst these. And it's a very impressive. It's already a very impressive, you know, way already achieved by Freetown, and it would be really great to proceed on this. I think we can move one slide further, please, on the key guiding principles. The CFF is demand driven. That means we expect cities have to apply for CFF support, and it's a very rigorous and competitive application process. There have been cities, Kuala Lumpur, Mumbai, Cape Town, you know, Mexico City, applying for CFF support, and Freetown has been successful with its application. We are city focused. This means, of course, we receive an application and we then tailor-made the support, tailor-made the studies needed for making progress on the cable car project in this context. We are, as the cities as well, outcome oriented. We want to see these projects being realized. We want to see they, you know, being implemented and making use of. And I think we have a very good track record. I will come to this later on. Then looking at transformative character of the projects is as well very important for us. In this context, it's a new technology being implemented. It's new not just for Freetown, Sierra Leone. It will be new for, I would say, for Western Africa, right? And this would be a really a live lighthouse project in Western Africa if implemented. So equitable and inclusive as well, a very important key aspect for us in the CFF support, and the cable car delivers on this as well. I will come to this in more detail later. Maybe we can go one slide, please, forward. So let me explain what the track record of the CFF is, or, you know, what have we done in the past, just to give you an impression on, you know, we are not just providing studies, but these studies, they lead to something and getting projects really getting implemented. And we see here, as you can see, this is our last funding phase. And we have quite big cities, Mexico City, Rio de Janeiro, Jakarta, Monterrey, Mexico, Dar es Salaam. And we supported in the past public transport, solar PV installation. And this is as well like very much related to the project we are looking here. A cable car, and if all 50% of these projects have been implemented already, the other 50% are on stage to get implemented. And you see, if all projects are implemented, then the CFF would leverage an investment volume of $650 million in climate-proof urban infrastructure. We are cutting down 2.5 million tons of greenhouse gas emissions if all projects are implemented. And this is as well kind of why we've been receiving the UN Global Climate Action Award in the category of sustainable finance in 2020. And let me go one slide further, please, and go into one of the examples I've been responsible for as a project manager in the past. This is the example of DKI Jakarta. I've chosen this example because it's very much related to the Freetown context. So it was a new technology being implemented. In Jakarta and Indonesia, electric buses is a new topic. And we supported them on feasibility studies and so forth. And as well from the project size, it's similar to the Freetown cable car project. It's a transport project. It is a public-private partnership model that we implemented. So the public sector coming in, the private sector coming in, financing the buses, the electric buses, maintaining and operating the buses for a fee per kilometer being paid by the city. And so I really like this example because as well it got implemented, and maybe you can see here our German ambassador working in DKI Jakarta, and he was standing there at the kickoff event and looking out, he recorded this, right? And he was looking out of his window and said, like, I oversee here the corridors of Jakarta, main transport corridors, and it would be so great to see electric buses running down there. And in March this year, the first 100 electric buses have been introduced to the network of Jakarta, are running on the roads, and this is quite, you know, this is what we would like to see, and this is the outcome of our CFF support, of course, jointly being implemented with the city, right? It's not us doing the work, it's a joint endeavor with the city. And I think with this, I would like to turn to give the floor to Modupe, the mayor, Honorable Mayor, and Modupe Williams to now go to the explaining the cable car. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Marco. Is the next set of slides up? Oh. Is this aware? Okay. Honorable Ambassador, Heads of Missions, World Bank, UN, GIZ, UN, the Deputy Minister of Planning and Development, the councillors of Freetown City Council, Chief Administrator, and all of our guests. We are really, really thrilled to have you all here today. And Marco, representing C40 Finance Facility, and Max, who's here somewhere, a special welcome to you. It's been a journey for us, and the journey starts with Transform Freetown. Everything that Marco has said, that others have said, have confirmed that what this represents is our understanding as a city of what our challenges are, our defining what a solution could be, and then our collaborating with partners through competition sometimes to get to this stage. Next slide. On this point, Freetonians, most of you are aware that Transform Freetown really seeks to take a comprehensive approach to dealing with the challenges of our city, whether those are access challenges, whether they're sanitation challenges, whether they're environmental challenges, or indeed, whether they're mobility challenges. So Transform Freetown has its four clusters of resilience, human development, healthy city, and urban mobility. And under urban mobility, those specific challenges are what we are seeking to address through this intervention. And this intervention will address more than the challenges, more than just urban mobility challenges, but they will be key. So what's the first one? Our population, the population of our city has grown exponentially in recent years. For those of us who live in the informal settlements, those of us who move through Eastern Police Area, or indeed Lumley at any hour of the day or night, you will know that Freetown's population is growing, not reducing. And with that growth also comes the need for more passenger movement. So we're looking currently, based on a World Bank study in 2018, we're looking at Freetown's public transport needing to move up to 14,000 passengers per hour. But we also have a situation where that transport, and this is why I said the challenges we're seeking to address are not limited to urban mobility, because transport is what moves you. Whether you need to move to school, whether you need to move to a clinic, whether you need to move to work. So because of that, we need more access, particularly for those hillside communities, in order for them to access, more access to transport, in order for them to access education and healthcare. But what do we see? I don't know what your journey was like to work this morning or to this event. I'm not sure how much time you spent in traffic, but I'm guessing it was considerable, because we've seen congestion rise in the city, particularly in that east-west corridor. And with that congestion, and with the age of our vehicles, means we also have more greenhouse gas emissions, CO2. And we know, most of us know, and if you don't, I can share with you, that when it comes to global greenhouse gas emissions, Africa is not the major player. We represent less than 4% of greenhouse gas emissions globally. So one might ask, why do we care? Well, we care because greenhouse gas emissions don't just affect the ozone layer, they affect your lungs. When you're sitting in that traffic and you're breathing in the fumes from the porta-porta behind you and the old taxi that's probably not meant to be on the road in front of you, that smog, that carbon monoxide that you are inhaling leads to lung cancer, leads to respiratory diseases. So we care about CO2 emissions in the Freetown context. And so we're wanting to reduce that. And we're also wanting to make sure that we're linking communities closer together. I'm pressing? Right. What have we had? We've seen isolated communities emerging in the hillsides and in the slums as our population has increased. And there isn't really much of a way to connect them. For those of you who might know communities like Moiba, communities like Sumaila Town, getting up to Mayinkine, it really is a trek. And very often you hear of situations where a woman who is pregnant loses the baby because she can't get down, she can't access public transport. What this will be doing, we'll be addressing this and many other challenges, including making transport safer. So as Marco said, in order for us to win that competition, in order for us to be selected to go through that application process successfully, we as a city needed to have done some work. This morning I was on AYV and I was explaining the journey that we have gone through. The journey that started with the articulation of what a solution might be. I remember very distinctly sitting in the old mayor's parlor when a gentleman was Mr. Nickel. I'm looking at Madupe. Alex Nickel. Alex Nickel is here today. Could you just, I'd just like to acknowledge you. Alex came into our office. He made an appointment to see Madupe. And he came and said to us, Mayor, you know what we should do for Freetown? A cable car. That's how the conversation started, with a single meeting. And then through a process of research, of studies, of engagement, of me meeting the mayor of Medellin, which is the city that started the first mass public transit cable car system, we moved forward. We engaged the Ministry of Environment and EPA. We did a co-funding application, which sadly was unsuccessful. And then through our membership of C40 Cities, having built up this body of work and done our own pre-feasibility, we were able to put in an application, which today means we are now on the path to implementation.
Where the line run, you'll realize that we're meeting this. And Freetown City Council, we've already said, is a member of C40 Cities. I happen to be the vice chair for C40 Cities, under the title of Innovator Cities. And that's what we bring. As Marco was saying, C40 is a collection and network of mega cities. You need to have a population of over 3 million to join C40 Cities, or in fact be invited, because it's an invitation, it's by invitation the network. We have a population of no less than 1.2 million. Actually, the calculation based on the 2015 study, a census, which the World Bank published in 2018, estimated that by 2028 our population would be 2 million, and that round about this time our population slopes to 1.5 million. And I don't know that data. Please go back. So on that, very, very important point. Because our membership of C40 Cities, what enables us to have this kind of collaboration is an appreciation that although our city population is less than 3 million people, there are two things that come into play. One, projections done based on our previous census, other data on where our population will be by 2030. That's one. But two, and this is, a compliment to us as a team, all of us, and I want to recognize our chief administrator and the partnership that we're enjoying today. This is based on a second very important point, and that is innovation. We are in C40 Cities because the innovation that we demonstrated to Freetown, the Tree Town,
through our sanitation initiatives, and now through this intervention of the cable car, these innovations, commitment to climate action is why, even though our population is currently between 1.2 and 1.5 million people, even though we're under the 3 million, that's why we're 640 cities. So we have a commitment to clean air through 640 cities membership, which this intervention will enable us to meet. So with that, I'd now like to call on our colleague, Madupe Williams, Engineer Madupe Williams, who was in that meeting with Alex Nickel all those months ago, over 2.5 years ago now, and who, although he works here on a pro bono basis, has been dedicated and worked so hard to ensure that we not only move forward with the pre-feasibility, but that we were successful in making this application for the funding for the school feasibility study. Engineer Madupe Williams, the floor is yours. I think you didn't have time for the technical bit, so I'm sorry about that.
Thank you very much, Madam Mayor. Honourable Minister, distinguished guests from our foreign partners, councillors, members of the council staff,
as soon as you go back,
and
meet
with them, what did they do?
see the screen. So you target and you zoom out from that. I'll tell you before you go into your stance.
To present aspects of the Freetown cable car. Yes, we in the council, when we are presenting this project, decided to undertake pre-feasibility study in-house using existing data. So the first aspect of the data was to use the demographic data. For the 2014 Freetown structure plan, which gave us a sense of urban settlements, population growth, and future trends in population settlements. We also used some data from the World Bank funded urban mobility project, which provided all the traffic counts along the corridors within the Freetown peninsula area. Coupled with that, we reviewed case studies of a number of other cities that had implemented the CableCar successfully. We engaged with these cities in understanding what are the opportunities and challenges in implementing a CableCar as a solution to address and regenerate a busy urban city like Freetown. We were also supported by a major CableCar manufacturer who came to Freetown and provided all the technical analysis and assessment of the sites we had identified for the CableCar route. And they supported us in building up cost estimates, both in terms of capital investment costs, but also the operating costs and the maintenance costs. So what we have is a full life cost solution for the CableCar, which is what we presented to the C40 Finance Facility for doing the competition and the call for support. And this concluded in us producing two business cases. One was an economic case showing the overall benefits to society and to the city of the cable car. We also produced a commercial case, which would allow a potential funder to see how they recover their investments if they put money into the CableCar for Freetown. And last but not least, but most importantly, we also consulted a number of other government departments, including the Ministry of Transport, the EPA, the Ministry of Lands and various states, the Ministry of Finance and various states in our discussions in how to take the CableCar forward. Next slide, please. So what's the CableCar? Fortunately for us, we had some videos out here today, which shows the CableCar operation. But the CableCar is effectively a small car, which is in the photograph on my left, which runs on the cable. It has a capacity of about 8 persons in each car, and it runs between cables and between stations. As the cable car approaches the station, it detaches from the main cable and comes onto the cable at the station. It decelerates, comes to the station, people get off, and it goes round the pulley at the center, and people join the cable car at the other side of the station. So it has an alighting side and a joining side of the cable car. So if you saw the video, you can see how the cable car operates at the station. But there are no intermediate stops. So it's pulled continuously by this cable, and the cable is quite a secure piece of infrastructure. Shall we move on to the next slide, please? So some of the technical aspects of the cable car, which I often get asked, power supply is the most common one. How can Freetown support this technology? In terms of power demand and power output, it's probably the lowest possible mass transit solution in terms of power demand. The driving output power is 630 kilowatt hours, and the starting output is 630, but the driving output as a continuous power demand is about 450. When you start the system in the morning, it draws a high level of power, but during the day, it runs about 450 kilowatt hours. I mean, that's is achievable. The building that's FCC, in this building, I think, has a similar
level of power demand when we have all the systems running, air conditioners and everything else. So it's not insurmountable in terms of meeting the demand of the power of the cable car. It's not energy hungry like other mass transit systems like tramways and metro systems. In terms of operability and maintainability, the procurement solution will determine how effective we can operate this cable car system. The current proposal that's being considered is for DBFO solution, design, build, finance, and operate. So a consortium will come together of manufacturers, maintainers, and financiers that will be have the necessary capacity to operate and maintain the cable car. This will include most likely a cable car manufacturer within that consortium. The safety is also another consideration. Generally, where most cable cars have been used as a mass transit solution since 2016, they've had to implement the cable car regulations that operate within the EU. So the discussions we've been having with the cable car manufacturer is that we will implement legislation in Sierra Leone to set up the assurance framework that will guarantee the levels of safety of the cable car at the same level as you would have within an EU country. So the laws and the governance system, the testing regimes, the assurance regimes, the controls will all be put in place prior to bringing the system into operation. That's generally considered as good practice for cable car systems. The next slide, please. So these are the three possible routes. The route we are considering here today is the East Corridor route, the Eastern route, which has a starting station in the central business district within the close proximity of the bus station. There's also a possible alternative location within the Victoria Park, And then the next station will be at Eastern Police Station around the annual school, and it will continue up into the hillside bypass alongside the bypass to service those communities that are completely have no road access at all. There's a huge community on that side of the bypass with no road access, and it will finish off in more likely at Kisi Ferry Junction and provide an interface with the current ferry terminal. So that's the pilot route. We have a proposal to extend the pilot route at some stage in the future to Wellington. The second route that's planned, or that we hope will be planned and funded, will be the Western route, which will start in Lumley, go up to Botomango in Wilberforce, come down to the National Stadium, and connect back into the CBD. And the third route, which we're calling the Mountain route, will start at the National Stadium and continue into Dwazak, up into Tree Planting, Leicester Village, come through Fabre College campus, and finish off at either Mountain Court the Hillside Bypass, Mountain Court, or at Eastern Police Station. Those are the three lines being considered at present. Next slide, please. As the mayor mentioned, we are proposing to working with the World Bank funded project IROMP to ensure that the proposals under the bus improvement corridor are complemented by the cable car. The bus improvement corridor starts from number 2 to Juwe, and road transport makes up most of the transport emissions. 98% of the transport emissions come from road transport. So by addressing the transport problems in our city, we have the potential to reduce our carbon emissions quite significantly. And up up to 2.8 million grams of carbon dioxide are emitted every year. Yeah. So the cable car can save up to 2.8 million of that. A third of the peak hour traffic can be accommodated by the cable car. The cable car takes about 6,000 people an hour, maybe a little under that. And the peak hour demand for most for the most congested parts of the city is about that. It's about 6,000 to 8,000 vehicles per hour. And as the mayor pointed out, that's due to increase to about 14,000 vehicles per hour by 2028. So this intervention can significantly reduce congestion and also reduce carbon emissions. Next slide, please. Allied to carbon emissions, which has a more long-term and global impact, we also have air quality. Although they're very similar, but air quality is more localized and its effect on the communities that are in close proximity to those emissions is more immediate. So in terms of air quality, road transport contributes to 36% of the toxic air transport air quality emissions in our city. And this graph we show there of the sulfur dioxide emissions in Freetown, this is work done by EPA in 2018, shows the range of emissions at different times of the day. And we also have the 2.5 we also have the particulate matter at 2.5 micrograms, and these emissions are dangerous to health. And one of the greatest causes of premature death in many cities in the world on the increase is exposure to poor air quality from carbon emissions. And in Africa, especially in West Africa, it's one of the high increasing causes of death. The other causes of death are on the decrease, while exposure to poor air quality is on the increase. Okay, next slide, please. Okay, this slide tries to depict the effect of vehicle speed. Vehicles are most polluting when stationary, when engines are left to run stationary or in congested networks. And this also is a problem with congestion. Vehicles are parked for long periods and you have people sat there selling their ware, exposed to congestion and vehicle emissions all day long. And this is a significant health risk to those communities. Shall we press on, please? Yeah. So I mentioned earlier we've done a business case, and this is some of our initial findings. At setting the ticket price at 5,000 leones per trip, which is now 5 leones. Yes, in new money it's 5 leones. Yes. Shall we scroll down, please? Yeah. With a capital cost of between 36 and 40 million, that's not an exact figure. We've done some sensitivity analysis. The benefit cost ratio of the project is about 1.8. So for every pound we spend, we get close to £2 back over the life of the project. And the payback in terms of return on capital borrowed is about 12 years. So that's the estimated business case, but this will need to be reviewed further with more accurate studies and more detailed analysis of financial scenarios. Shall we go on to the final slide? The key message I would like to to share here today is the importance of stakeholder involvement in delivering a successful and integrated transport system for Freetown. We have identified these as the key government stakeholder ministries that need to be on board in driving this project to a successful financial close. And each of them have their own unique contribution based on the mandates they have and the areas of responsibility. And this is just a summary of what, I won't read that, I just leave that up there for you to see how your ministry has played a key part in the success of this pilot cable car project. Thank you very much.
Now that we've gotten the technical details, I could hear people breathe a sigh of relief. Because some people were scared initially. How is this going to happen? Are we going to be stuck mid-air? So thank you so much for that, Modupe. I believe that in Sierra Leone, most times we look up to the west side of Freetown for good stuff. So I think this is breaking the norm and going to the east. Mi eastern fambulo na dea. I can't hear you. So for the first time, we're starting from the east, where we have tons of businesses. That is where the heart of the city is, isn't it? And this is where we're starting. So can we clap for our city? And can we say hooray for Sierra Leone? Hooray. Well done. To continue on in terms of what was done behind the scenes, the findings, what they gathered, and why is it happening now, we're going to call again a familiar face. He's promised to make it very short, but detailed. Let's welcome Dr. Mako.
Thank you so much, Ariana. You're the best. Thank you, Honorable Mayor and Modupe Williams, for making the strong case for the cable car and maybe turning back to the CFF logic and perspective on this project. Maybe we can have the slides back on the screen. Let me just... Could we have the slides back on the screen? Then. I, as promised, will keep it short. I think everything has been said, but I just wanted to as well explain very briefly why we, the CFF, have selected and the funding partners ultimately have selected the cable car project here in Freetown. Just a couple of slides further, please. You are going backwards. Maybe you could there we go. One, yeah, there. And maybe just go one slide further, please. And here again, I think it's really worthwhile mentioning again how we, the CFF, select our partner cities. And so it's a very competitive and rigorous city selection process. So we received from 70 mega cities, first tier cities, applications, in total 86 applications. And as said, we shortlisted, or we, there we go, thank you so much. So you can see here the numbers and the criteria we apply in order to select the cities. So we expect a certain level of maturity already of the projects, right? We expect a very tangible project that really has the potential to get realized, implemented. We select, we have a look at the completeness, of course, of the applications we receive. And so we step by step turn down the number. And you can see as well the criteria to select the city. So in total now we are having 14 cities. So we are part of a very nice sample of mega cities, first tier cities here within C40 Cities Finance Facility. And let me go very briefly one slide further and explain. So we are having several stages of selecting the cities, and we as well have a due diligence mission, as we call it, 1 week where we conduct interviews with all key stakeholders to find out, to gain a throughout understanding on the project and what the CFF support would look like. And I think it's part of a transparent process. We always identify for all our cities this risks as well with the project. I'm coming as well to the benefits, but to be transparent throughout. So we, as it's a new technology being implemented, it's we face, of course, financing risks. There is no financial model being in place and having proven that this is possible. There is a political risk, as there is campaigns upcoming, and you know, we are funded just until March 2024, and in our experience, we have with other C40 cities, we have experienced that projects get a little bit slowed down, and so we couldn't implement to the extent we wanted and support the city to the extent we wanted in the past on other cities. So this is not just risks we see in Freetown, but these are risks we see with all our cities, and the narrative is slightly different, but I think it's important to name, and as well maybe looking at the capacities within the city administration. As said, it's a new technology, so we can't expect the city administration to be familiar with the cable car. It's a risk we address here, and where we have to identify a mitigation measure. But this just for having a full picture on the cable car. Then please go one slide further. Now coming to you know, the transformer. The aspect we are looking a lot at is transformation and upscaling potential. So it's a pilot cable car route, has been explained. From our perspective, having the potential to really act as a catalyst for larger transformational change within the city, Freetown and Sierra Leone. It's the Eastern Line, the pilot route, being one out of four routes, and so there is as well this upscaling potential, as we call it. And now turning, it has been already made the case, but this is, you know, our CFF perspective as an external party looking at the cable car. It's a very innovative mass transit solution. It has been proven, especially in Latin America. So it would, if implemented, improve the public transport capacities, so the numbers of transport, people making use of the public transport. It would reduce road congestion, contribute to a formal integrated public transport system. It would enhance equitable access to public services, reduce greenhouse gas emissions and air pollution. I think it's very important, has been stressed already by the Honorable Mayor and Modupe Williams. It would increase safety for women as well and comfort. It's looking at the build-up environment of Freetown, it's compared to other mass transit solutions, it has a very small impact on the build-up environment. So if you would construct a BRT, a dedicated bus lane, you would have to remove maybe certain buildings or so, but the cable car is floating over the roofs of Freetown. And I think there is then several stations, but the build-up environment has a smaller impact on the build-up environment, and therefore as well, comes at lower cost compared to other solutions, mass transport solutions. It supports achieving national and municipal agendas. It has been outlined as well. and it would be very complementary to urban mobility initiatives being provided, as said, from the World Bank, for instance. So this is our summarized, you know, perspective on the cable car. Maybe we can go one slide further, having a very brief look at the climate impact. I think it has been said, if implemented, it would really make a huge contribution on saving CO2 emissions. We estimated on a rough calculation around 10,000 tons CO2 per year. It would significantly impact air quality within the city, has been stressed already. And if we consider solar PV as well, or renewable energy to provide, or you know, make the cable car run, then this could be a zero emission solution and would make the city resilient compared, or as we now experience every day, against increasing fuel prices, highly volatile fuel prices, and making the city more resilient against this as well. And maybe one more slide on equity and inclusion. Thanks for moving forward. So it's a safe, reliable mode of transport, especially against the rapidly increasing public transport demand that has been as well outlined within Freetown. It would allow accessibility of the hillside communities to the central business district, the main market locations, interchanges to buses and ferries, terminals, and looking at job creation as well, we see an estimate around 2,200, you know, people getting employed during the construction phase, and around 70 long-term jobs being attached to the cable car for maintenance and operation of it. So then coming very briefly to the CFF contribution, it has been said already, we would like to support the city on really proving this cable car project from a technical, financial perspective, have a look at the environmental and social impacts, come up with a tailor-made business case. And I think a very key element to this project, as well as community engagement, and provide the training needed to be ready to move forward on this cable car project. And maybe coming to my final slide, just to give you an idea, so it's not a project we are speaking about to get implemented within, at like in December starting or so. No, we are starting now today here in Freetown. And by next week, we will already have technical workshops with city officials, with hopefully government officials, taking, you know, being part of these technical workshops to get a throughout understanding on the project, whom to involve, at what stage, and define the work packages needed to move forward on the project. We are currently recruiting a dedicated staff person that would coordinate on the project between the city, the C40 city's finance facility, and all the other key stakeholders to this project. And yeah, of course, we are as well on the stage to recruit an international expert team to provide the support needed in order to bring this project forward. So this is from my side. Thank you so much, and looking forward to implement this project.
Thank you so much, Marco. As we round up, it will be terribly unfair to not hear from the beneficiaries. Isn't that so? People like us, business owners, students, someone like a counselor who gets to interact with tons of different people every day. So in the next couple of minutes, we're going to have...
You take your time to
figure it out. Yes. Mr. Bassoon, what are your thoughts? How do you think it will change the lives of Freetonians?
Well, I would like to commend the mayor for coming up with the dream. I should caution, it is a dream, but we have to try and get it to reality. We have to think about the feasibility, because the feasibility would show whether it would happen or not. The feasibility will show if it will be sustainable, which is a very important factor, because when you're talking about private sector getting involved in this, they want to see the money. If they don't see the money, they would not go into it. So I would like to urge the international organizations to think of it as, yes, let it be a private public venture, because from the early figures that we've started seeing, 5,000 leones or 5 leones might not be affordable for some people. So I think the feasibility study will prove things, but I would urge the international organizations to maybe offer some grants or aid to help cover it. Let it be a reality, because it's something that we really need, and it would help lives of a lot of people, the Freetonians especially, and then the emission controls, it would help. And I urge the international organizations to look at that. Thank you.
Thank you. We value your opinions and your feedback, Mr. Bassoon. But just to piggyback on that, you mentioned that 5 leones might be unaffordable for some people. I think we should see the hands. 5 leones, how many thousand leones did you spend for Okada, my students? Poda. From Wellington to the council this morning. 10,000. And I'm talking to the students, no mature adults, you can make money. Students, how much did you pay? So we're supporting with the feasibility studies now. 10 leones is what most of them paid. So I think we're making progress gradually. Good. Thank you, Councillor. Councillor is from the very area where they're going to benefit. That's the Wellington region. So, Councillor, how do you think this will change, transform, influence the lives of your constituents?
Being a victim of the problem of transportation in my own community, I'm so much excited, because thinking of my location to here, every day I spend more than 30,000 coming, if you want to come quicker. So let me tell you that the people of Wellington are so much excited if they got this news about this cable car. Did you know that I was expecting that the transportation will be 100,000 leones or 100 leones? When I get it, that is 5 leones, I was so much excited. Because looking at the Okadas, they don't even have a normal price. They charge you and you pay. If you save 10,000 leones, another one will say, I pay 15,000 leones. And they look for the person that will pay the higher price. They take along with that person. So I'm so much excited with this project. Could you imagine? 5 leones from Wellington to the Freetown, to the city. 5 leones. I'm so much excited. And I believe and I'm confident that the people that have been living here will be beneficiary someday.
Thank you. At this rate, I think our funding partners need to start thinking about more money, because we need more cars. Because what I hear from councillors is that the demand is high.
Of course, because it deals with money.
It deals with money.
Yeah.
Thank you. Khadija too, are you ready for us? Do you want to share how this would change your grandmother's life, your sister's life?
Calm down. You can do this. Don't look at
Hello, people. Hello. We have a new generation member here. Okay? And the cable car is here because of them. Yes, how do you think this will change your life, your community's life? Just one word. Okay. All right, Khadijatu. One word. Just one word.
It's
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah. Khadija, applause.
We got backup.
Ready?
We got backup.
Okay, let's go. How do you feel? Let's talk about it. Just talk like you're talking to me.
It's reduced traffic congestion in Sierra Leone.
Okay, it's going to reduce traffic congestion in Sierra Leone. Okay, what's your name?
My name is Asturaim.
Asturaim? Yeah. Astur, what do you think? How do you think this is going to affect your life and the life of your family? You come sit here. Let's see. Come on, Khadija, let's move. Let's share the space. Here we go. So you tell us, as a young woman, how do you think this is going to affect? Did you watch the whole thing? Did you see it all?
Yeah.
Okay, tell us what your thoughts.
My life is going to improve more because my parents work to go and do some business, and I'm so happy. I don't know what to do. I'm so excited for these things. I don't know what to do. I'm very, very happy. I want to shout on top of my voice to celebrate my happiness. But thank you, people, to help us for transportation business.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So I'm going to start with you. So this is the last round of questions. When you were heading here, when you were coming,
yes, ma'am.
What were you afraid about? What were you afraid of when they said cable car? What were
At first, I was furious that the electricity. I don't know what to talk. Stop laughing. I'm learning. Right? I'm learning.
Yeah.
Oh, it's perfect.
Good.
Yes.
Yes, please go ahead.
I don't know how to talk, but I'm taking it. When I said the cable car, I was furious. Yes, honestly. But I think it's very good for us. But me, up to now, I'm furious. But for my parents, I know they are very happy that they are going to get the news that a cable car is here for them, to support them through the transportation business.
So you mentioned that you felt as if it might get stuck, electricity. What were you trying to say? Tell me, Pakriyo, for us.
I think currents go shock me.
Electricity.
Yes.
Is it a shock?
Yes.
Yes.
So that is why I'm furious.
You're curious.
Yeah. Yes. I think that is going to make me. I don't know what to say. Well.
And that's a valid fear, isn't that so? Yeah. For even for some of us in the audience as adults.
But now I don't.
Now, with these presentations, are you more comfortable?
Yeah.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah. So I noticed that we've got schools who, in the introduction, Madupe said the lines go over their schools. What's the name of your school and where is it?
Amadia Muslim Secondary School at Ferry Junction, Dockyard.
Oh, so your school is where the line will be.
Yes.
So you'll be direct beneficiaries. You'll be able to use the line to school. And this is Abbott Academy. So this is the Hillside Bypass. You'll be using the line that goes to Hillside Bypass. So you guys are actually going to have a better way to get to school. How many more years do you have in school?
Four
1 year. So this is going to come after you finished.
I have 2 years.
You'll be using the Febe College route.
I think I have 2 years.
Cancelo, yeah. What was your greatest fear?
When I came in this morning, I was standing there looking at the screen, mm-hmm. seeing the cable car moving one way or the other. I said, how is it going to move? But let me tell you, to be sincere, after all the deliberation and explanation, I've laid my fear because I believe I have confidence with all these partners and the technical ability of it. I know that everything will be okay at the end of the day.
Thank you. With the technicality,
of course.
So just Engineer Modipe and the team.
I know it's not only being Engineer Modipe, we have to get another support. I heard the young man saying that they are about to employ somebody that will support.
Excellent, thank you.
And I want to say special thanks to the High Honourable Lady, Her Worship the Mayor, because we are here today for. Yes! On behalf of the Transport Committee, I want to say kudos. Because we are the one that is having this particular project.
Thank you. And Mr. Bassoon, what's your fear? You've already started sharing. What's another fear?
No, the presentation about the technical. I was initially scared about the safety, but you know that's been sorted out. Safety issue, maintenance. He's talked about it. And also the model, the thinking about having somebody operating it, which is good as well. So no, apart from that, everything's okay for that. Technically, all is good.
So the launch has gone on well.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. No. Do you feel that way yourself?
Yeah. Well, let me say something. My biggest fear was that this cable car coming to Sierra Leone, I still don't think about the electricity status in the country. Mm. Presently, the electricity status in the country is not stable, so that was one of my fear, and I was not really cool with that, but based on what Mr. Modupe and the other man, I don't know the name, say, Mr. Mako, I'm a little bit confident and I'm okay with it because at the end of it all, the betterment of my country, my city, to be precise, and I'm okay with that.
Thank you so much. Khadija, do you want to say goodbye?
No, I can't. Sorry.
Okay, you're going to say something? Okay, wait, you need the mic. A speech?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
Sit down. Yeah, Worship Mayor, representative from Germany, Greece, France, and my fellow Sierra Leoneans. Assalamu alaikum, Asma.
Thank you. So thank you so much. We've had a little. It's made us laugh. It's made us think. And the journey has just started. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. Thank you. We're starting to compete with another city.
Yes.
Thank you.
It's been a beautiful morning, lots of excitement, great hope for the future. The journey has started now. We want to call on our able administrator to come give us the closing remarks. Mr. Festus.
Your Excellency, the Ambassador of Germany, I worship the Mayor of Freetown Municipality, Mrs. Yvonne Akisoya, Councillors present, the Deputy Minister of Planning and Economic Development, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to stand on all existing protocol. This event today is indeed a groundbreaking event. Never in our lives have we dreamt about cable car technology as a mode of transportation in Freetown. We have learned today that a cable car is a type of cable railway used for mass transit in which all rail cars are hauled by continuously moving cables at a constant speed. Those of us who have been hearing about it, about this project and its installation as a mode of transportation in Freetown, but had no knowledge of what it is all about, have been filled with a lot of information today. We hope the team of journalists present here today will do justice in propagating this initiative to the general populace. This Freetown Cable Car pilot project, which when initially expressed, was considered by some pundits as a pipe dream, must now realize that it is indeed a reality. We are very excited because this technology will greatly contribute in moving large numbers of commuters at any given point. Transit time will be significantly reduced, carbon dioxide emission and that of other forms of pollution associated with traffic congestion will also be greatly reduced, thus implementing the global challenge of climate change in our own small ways. Freetown in particular and the nation in general have been suffering from inadequate transportation system, the regular occurrences of accidents with some being fatal, the rickety nature of some of the vehicles with their constant breakdowns, the non-availability of proper organized public transport system, the regular accidents by commercial motorbikes and tricycle, which you call keke, are amongst the problems faced by the commuting public. As I've already commented, the introduction of the cable car system is a bold initiative for this nation in general and the Freetown in particular. At this point, I want to thank the government of Sierra Leone and the local counterparts that have been collaborating with the Freetown City Council, and more especially, our gratification goes to our partners, GIZ, the C40 City Climate Leadership Group, that are implementing on behalf of the German Federation Ministry for Economic Cooperation and Development. The AFD, the government of the United Kingdom, and a host of others are playing a critical role in this exercise. We hope that this collaboration will continue in other spheres, for the development of Sierra Leone as we transform Freetown. Lastly, I shall be remiss if I fail to express our sincerest thanks and appreciation to Her Worship the Mayor for the initiative. Yes, for the initiative and also the team of experts that relentlessly work with her for the realization of this dream. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for that to the Chief Administrator. We have a very critical partner in the room. I actually have a fine for initially not acknowledging him, and that is the Country Director of GIZ, Mr. Christian Widnon. He will come give us his closing remarks. We're looking forward to hearing from him. Welcome him to the stage.
The Mayor of Freetown, representatives of ministries, departments and agencies, the German Ambassador, development partners, ladies and gentlemen, students, I'm standing on existing protocols and I wish you good afternoon. Good morning still, actually. This has been really an inspiring morning also for myself, and I really enjoyed following the presentations and the discussion here. I want to start by thanking everybody for coming today. It is great to see so many of you, of these key stakeholders in this room, showing interest in realizing this ambitious cable car project. It has been highlighted by many of the speakers today. Partnerships are key to this project on all levels. CFF and GIZ have built a very successful cooperation with C40 cities in realizing ambitious climate action projects. The two organizations complement each other, and our respective strengths are particularly important in this project. C40 is an organization that unites cities with ambitious and innovative climate agendas. They work directly with municipal governments, like the one of Freetown. GIZ, on the other hand, has a long track record in working with national ministries, even here in Sierra Leone. I'm convinced that if all parties work together, we could realize a lighthouse project for Western Africa. The outlined cable car project is a great start towards a transition to a climate-neutral economy. GIZ stands ready to work together with all local, national, and international stakeholders to improve the way of life for all citizens and to contribute building a more resilient city of Freetown. However, we also need to encourage additional key partners from the private sector, development finance institutes, and possibly even additional development partners to come on board, making this very ambitious project a reality. Finally, let me close with this. Imagine we would now close this event and ride home in a cable car. In a safe, environmental friendly, and fast mode of transport, instead of being worried of the ever increasing fuel prices. Thank you very much and have a nice afternoon.
Thank you so much, Mr. Christian Widman, for that. Did you really think about it? Did you imagine? Imagine going home in a cable car. Close your eyes and imagine that. I see $1 million smiles everywhere, and it is happening. And this is why we've been here for the last couple of minutes. Can we recognize the efforts of all of the partners, the funding partners, implementing partners, but more especially that of our city? Can we recognize that?